How's it going, everybody? Spotted Bass Stalker here with the tip for you on how to catch more bass this weekend with the frogs. When we reason them on top, we know sometimes they strike short at the legs or they blow them up out of the water. And they don't really ever get anywhere near these main hooks on top, which they have to chomp down pretty hard to get on top of. Okay, so what we're going to do is we're going to take and turn our frog, invert it so we can get to the hooks. Okay, got our hooks here. We're going to take some treble hooks here. Small treble hooks. Take them so that they don't fit on any direction except when you turn them around backwards. Then you can slide them on. Take your other one, do the same thing. See them dangling down like that, okay? We're going to go ahead and spin our body back around. Be careful. This is where you're going to stab yourself on all those extra hooks hanging around. Okay, there we go. Bring them down into position behind the legs. Sometimes they'll wrap in the legs a little, and this will actually keep them from catching any you know, weeds that might be a little deeper. You don't want to throw this in an area where there's slop, where there's a lot of hydrilla and a lily pad, because you're going to end up catching these. But this is on occasion when, you know, you're throwing them along the pads, throwing them in an area where the weeds are submerged, but the bass are still striking pretty heavy and everything like that, but they're just coming up and nipping or striking at it too late. First time I modified one of my frogs and did this, I caught 20 bass out of 20 on this same style of frog the first time I done it. 18 of them I caught on the trebles. I wouldn't have caught those bass at all if it wasn't for the trebles. Two of them I caught on the main hooks, which bit far enough into the body to be able to get it. Now, these aren't going to work for you all the time, like I said, in the slop and everything like that, but in a clear open water, it will work great. And just keep a couple of them in your tackle box or your tackle tray and throw them on if they're short striking. So hopefully this will catch you some more bass this weekend, some big ones. And if you like this, give me a like, give me a thumbs up, give me a share. Maybe not to your best bass buddies, though, because, you know, they're going to catch bigger bass than you. Peace out, guys. See you.